let's talk about the podcast growth. You know, what have been some of the, like, the biggest needle movers for actually getting people to pay attention to the show?
Yeah, I mean, there's a ton of different ways that you can approach it. But at the end of the day is, when you look at podcast growth, word of mouth is still the number one way. Like, you can run ads all you want, but that's so pricey. You can do all these things, but word of mouth is the number one way. So what I always say to people is, impact the small audience you have to begin with in such a deep way that you're the third podcast they mention. Hmm. Right? And the reason I say the third one is because everybody listens to Rogan. So when somebody says, oh, what podcast do you listen to? They listen to Rogan. And the second one usually falls in line, at least in the categories that I'm in. It's either Gary Vee or Lewis Howes or something
Tim Ferriss.
Level. Yeah. Tim Ferriss, whoever, Andy Frisella, those guys, right? And then you want to be the third one. Oh, and I listen to the Growth Now Movement, or oh, I listen to Hustle and Flowchart, right?
Yeah.
The reason being, everybody listens to the first two they mention. When you're the third one, they go, oh, what's that one? I have to check it out, right? So serve your audience in such a deep way that you're talked about. Right. So pay attention to what they need and serve them. Second way is to get on podcasts that are on a similar level or higher level than you. And honestly, like, there might be five people that listen to your podcast that come and check out my show, and then they binge listen, they become super fans, and they grow that way. And that's a great way to do that. And so those are the two top ways, right? Like, when I'm not talking technical, like, just get on shows, get people talking about your show. Now, there are other things, right? Like, consistency is key. Like, that's something that I really, really preach. So I show up every single Tuesday at 3 a.m. for my audience. And I look at it like this. I'm humble enough to say that I'm not the best podcaster. I think I'm pretty good, and I've definitely gotten really good, you know, doing certain things over the last 4.5 years. But I also know that I'm not the best. So what happens is, I become a part of their routine every single Tuesday or whatever day they decide to listen. So say it's Tuesday, right? I'm the person they listen to while they're at the gym or when they're driving to work or when they're doing whatever on that Tuesday. If I'm not there for them, they're going to find something else to listen to. And that person's probably better, and they're going to go stay over there. They're not coming back. So consistency is super key when growing the podcast, because I found that when I disappear for a while, there's definitely some long-term drop-off, right? Like, I've only ever taken one long-term break, and that was pretty early on. But when I relaunched, it was really starting from day one. Like, it was like, okay, I'm rebuilding, right? I took about 3 months off, dropped a co-host that I had, and relaunched as just myself. But that's when I started to implement, stay true to your brand, right? Like, my branding and the messaging we were doing, because me and my co-host were on different levels, they weren't matched up. And so since that didn't match up, we weren't holding on to people. They'd come and find us somehow, right? Because back then there were a lot less podcasts. They'd come and find us somehow and listen. They go, this is not what was branded to me. They're talking about something completely off kilter, right? So that's super important. So I show up as my brand, and then I showed up consistently, and then I started to grow organically from that standpoint, right? And I hit all those targets that I was just talking about. And then I learned that the people you surround yourself with, even in this game, which seems to be very, like, solo, like, right? Like, when you're doing the podcast, you kind of feel like you're on your own kind of path. Like, there's nobody else doing this with me, and so on and so forth. But I started spending time with other podcasters and asking them what they do. Like, Jeremy Ryan Slade, I always give a shout out to, because he was the one that made me realize that podcasting can be your gig. Like, he made me realize it could be a business. So I started to learn the ins and outs, the important things, started to join some masterminds that focus on podcasting, and really start to understand, like, what are the things I can implement beyond just the idea of, like, okay, growth is important, but not that important. Yeah. There's so much more that you can do. And then after I started to grow and started to grow a little bit of a semi cult following, Inc. magazine listed me as a top 8 podcast, and everything kind of blew up. That opened me up to a much larger audience. I found out that Inc. article got read 180,000 times.
Whoa.
And so I was one of 8 on this list. And the other people were like Andy Frisella. I think Tim Ferriss was on it. Lewis Howes was on it. And, like, there's this other random show, and that was mine. And so I 4X'd my audience overnight. And the other thing is, though, I kept that audience. People can have spikes in podcasting, as I'm sure you guys have seen.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
You have spikes because you did something or you showed up somewhere or whatever. But then those people end up, a lot of times for most people, those people end up dying off because they're not consistent. Their branding isn't on point. All of these things. And so there's a mix of a bunch of different stuff, right? Like, I was also podcasting for 2 years before Inc. showed up. And so there's a lot that goes on into the space, but I guess I've shared a number of tips, right? Like show up, be consistent, branding on point, be, you know, make sure you're serving your audience. Like those are all things that you can do. And of course there are things beyond that as well, but those are the main focal points. And understanding, be patient, like especially now, like there's so many podcasts, you're not going to grow a consistent audience for most people unless you're already a big brand name. You're not going to grow a solid audience till you at least get to episode 100, because people aren't going to waste their time with you until you know that you're wasting your time, right? Yeah. Like they're going to make sure you're going to show up for them to truly commit to listening every single week.
Very selfish, but they should be.
Of course. Yeah. Well, it was funny. I was just on a podcast and I said something that I actually said at Podfest when I spoke at the last one. There's a room, I think there's like 160 people in my breakout room. And I go, one of the first things I said were podcasters are the most selfish, egotistical people I've ever met. Now keep in mind, this is a room of 160 podcasters.
They brain up at you.
It's ridiculous. But the idea is that like people have this podcast and they think they have this incredible platform where, I'm going to introduce you to new people and blah, blah, blah. But then you realize 80% of shows do less than 100 downloads an episode, but they still have that ego. And I'm like, what are you doing? Like if the people that you really want to have a conversation with, the play is, and I'm going to build your platform. The play is, hey, let's serve my audience.
Yes.
Right. Like let's do something really great. Let's inspire some people together. And if you can get out of your own way, I think people want to be involved with what you guys are doing. Like you guys are super humble. Matt, you're coming on the show here, my show shortly, but Joe, we had a 45-minute conversation on my podcast and I know what you guys do. I know that you serve your audience. I know that you do all these things and that's why you have the success in podcasting. People have it backwards. They're trying to serve themselves a lot more than they're serving others.
Yeah. Thank you. And you evolved, like you said, you know, when you started, it was about you more so, you know, the podcast. And I think it was for us as well.
We used to say it on our show. We're like, this is the most selfish podcast in the business space. We're bringing on people that we want to pick their brain for our own business. But over time, I think we had the same shift where it was like, now we're bringing on people that we want. So the show now is more like we want to introduce good people to our audience. But also we want to talk about the things that we've learned our audience is really interested in. So we've had a very similar shift. We don't call it the most selfish podcast in the space anymore.
Because it doesn't feel that way. Honestly, it's more of the giving. And I think that's why even going on podcasts, other podcasts, because we guest a lot as well. I'm curious your thoughts on this because we kind of had this, I don't know if it's a breakthrough or not, but realization like, okay, there's general shows out there. There's general business shows. There's general self-improvement shows. And then there's very specific things like, okay, there's business for SaaS founders. There's all these like very things. And we kind of realized, and we don't have any like perfect data on this. We're like, okay, well we can guest on maybe not other general business shows because that's kind of what we are, or a general marketing show, I guess. You know, like let's go a little bit more specific. So like go on that SaaS show that like we can attract them with our personality because we have more of this broad spectrum, not just this kind of micro, you know, laser focused thing. Do you have a strategy around that? Because I'm thinking if you kind of pair it up that way, or even if you have a specific show, go to a general show kind of thing to retain listeners rather than just get some and then have them drop off because it's kind of pointless then.
Yeah. And I mean, and like I said, most podcasters get that, right? They might get some, oh, I had a huge spike today. I'm like, yeah, well, what happened? Or yesterday? Well, what happened today? Right. People aren't sticking around.
Sure.
I mean, I think for me, like I'm not overly specific. And here's the thing. A lot of people ask me to be on their show to talk about podcasting. And so I'd say about 80% of the shows I've been on, like I'm the first 5 episodes, right? So it's like, okay, cool. I know you have 30 downloads, but I'm going to show up. But I've been really intentional over the last 6 months. I set an intention about between 4 to 6 months ago. I said, I want to be invited onto platforms of people that I truly respect, right? I want to be invited. I want to give to their audience. I want to pour into them. And the people I respect are the same people that are in my space, right? Like, so just recently, after setting that intention and working towards, David Meltzer was just recently on my show, but I was also on one of his shows. He's got multiple. I was just on the one called Office Hours, and then I was just invited onto his main podcast. Nice. And so for me, I've now gotten really intentional and truly reaching out to like the epic top tier podcast to say, hey, I want to serve your audience. And actually that happened through introduction by giving to somebody else. I then got introduced to David and then David liked me and I got invited on. And so that was a huge win for me. But again, that's all about like setting those goals and then those 1% every day to get there. But that's, so I've gotten just really intentional about it lately. I'll still do pretty much whoever asks me on, as long as their intention is the right, coming from the right place. I'll still do most podcasts, but yeah, I mean, to be in the same space I found is the way to go. Like, you guys are a little bit more broad. So am I, mm-hmm. but like, if I had a fitness podcast, I don't really want to go on one that's talking about tech. I'm not going to get any of those listeners.
Right. Yeah.
But you and I, like your show and my show, it can get broad. Like right now we're talking about enjoying life. You know what I mean? we can get super broad. So I don't mind going on certain shows. I've been on health shows and I'm far from the six pack abs, you know what I mean? And so, but a lot of that is self-development crossover. So sure. As long as there's some sort of crossover and I feel like I can add value to their audience, I'll do it.